You're listening to Knicksology on ESPN 1700. Buckle up, as anything goes, and having fun is the only rule we have. Now, here's your host, Nick Apostolopoulos.
Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to Knicksology, brought to you by 619 Vodka. Of course, you can always reach us on Facebook at facebook.com/Knicksology and Knicksology.com. We have a great show coming up for you today. Later on in the show, we have Jesse Arroyo, world-famed San Diego photographer, coming on so I can bitch at him about the Chargers Stadium stuff. It's just driving me crazy with that. Everyone I know who's a Charger fan is like, oh, they're staying. I'm like, they seem gone to me, but I don't know. Jesse will set us straight on that. And then later on, we have Jared Farver coming up with his great bourbon and beer-infused pickles. So we're going to talk about that later. But right now, first up, we have in the studio here, DJ Mancat. If you don't know DJ Mancat, and you live in San Diego, I feel sorry for you, because he's everywhere doing everything, DJing the fair, doing other events, working with the Belly Up, casting director I see on your bio here. What haven't you done, man?
I haven't danced for money yet, so...
Oh, well, we might figure that out by the end of this show.
Bucket list, man. Let's make it happen.
Yeah, cool. And his buddy Mark Hodges is here, who works at Holiday Wine Cellar, which we love because they carry 619 Vodka.
Oh, yeah.
So that's good. And I just found out they actually do tastings there now, so we're going to have to get that scheduled. Definitely. For our North County peeps. I got a bunch of people up there who love it, but yeah, that's the first place I've seen that allows us to do wet tastings. So,
yeah.
So that'll be cool.
That'll be real fun.
Yeah. Awesome. So... I want to get right to it, because we were in the green room and I had never heard this before, but among DJ Mancat's among his many vocations in life is he's occasionally an Uber driver.
That's right. Yeah, I decided to do Uber driving. I lost a good friend of mine to a drunk driver a while ago, and I started working with Uber with bars around the county. And when I was working with the bars, I'm like, all right, let's get Uber in here. It's an easy way for people under 30 or around that age to get taxis home.
Right. And I love it, especially being with 619 and everything. I don't have to park, pay for parking and deal with all that stuff, right? And then just the whole drinking and driving thing.
Yeah.
So it's awesome, yeah.
They have an app for that now, too. You can get someone to park your car.
Oh, really?
They got an app for everything, man.
Dude, you know, sorry, segue. You know what they have an app for, and I'm working on getting the guy on the show? There's an app now that will deliver booze to you.
I saw that.
It's called Saucy or something like that, and I'm trying to get them on the show. They'll deliver booze to you.
That is saucy.
It's absolutely crazy. No, totally. So anyway, so Uber.
Yeah, so I decided to partner up with Uber and with the bars around town so people can get home safe. I think the average was like DUIs went down 30% for people under 34 in San Diego last year.
Really?
That's
an awesome stat. Yeah, that's really cool.
We can't act like that's not Uber involved, and I know that from the people that I'm driving, because they're usually people who are
wasted,
and and they're like, I would never, you know, take a taxi. They, you know, so it's a nice way to, you know, instead of doing a $20 taxi, you can do a $6.
Not to do a whole Uber ad too, because I use Lyft and there are other ones out there. But you know, the whole thing for me with the taxis is they're behind the times, man. Because the biggest problem I used to have, just being downtown, I live in North Park, it's not that far, but it's 2 a.m. You leave the bar and try and get a taxi. Just try and get one.
Yeah.
If you call, they never show up. Try and wave one down, they're all full of people. The great part about the Uber and Lyft technology is they're, you know, you know your driver, they know you, they're coming to pick you up.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's way easier to you know, not that there's an excuse for driving drunk, but it's way easier to do when you've got that app at your fingertips.
People certainly make excuses.
Well, no, sure, and I'm not going to say I've never done that before either. Knock on wood, but you know, yeah, it's great. So all right, so your story. So you were I kind of came into the middle of this. So, so you picked girls up from downtown to take to PB?
Yeah, I was in Encinitas, and they were going to PB. So somewhere in La Jolla, they got a call that someone kissed their boyfriend's friend. So it turned into an Uber ride home to like, oh, hell no, let's go kick this girl's butt, you know? So they tell me repeatedly for the next 5 minutes I need to speed up, you know, because we have to go to the fight. So, you know, they were spending time coordinating who will hit who first, because, you know, little Mackie already has a rep around town for being crazy, so her counterpart Amy was going to hit first, and then Mackie could jump in later.
So wait, they're having a whole conversation, they're planning out the fight in advance.
Yes. Like,
who's going to hit who, and how they're going to do it, and...
Yeah,
which... Did they know this girl at all, or was it just some random...
I feel like they did know her, okay. Yeah.
So they were extra pissed that pissed somebody's boyfriend,
yeah.
Okay.
So, we're about to get to the destination, and they jump out, and the funny thing is, they wanted me to like speed up while we're going down Garnett, and you know anyone in San Diego knows
you can't do that.
It's like the
point of taking an Uber.
Yeah, it's like the paperboy game, and there's like break dancers and like crazy cat ladies. It's exactly like paperboy, actually. You know, so we get to the destination and they jump out of the car.
For those of you know under 30, that was a killer game back in the 80s. Killer video game, paperboy. Yeah, it was one of the best for yes. Sure. All right, so sorry, go ahead.
So they jump out of the car and they run up the house. I turn my Uber back on so I could pick up the next customer, but you know, I kind of wanted to sit there and watch the fight. But I instantly get a new rider, and I notice a pickup is at the same house that I just unleashed these drunken cat fight to. I also notice the name is the same of the girl that's about to get into the fight. So
Nicole.
I call her immediately, and you know. To tell her I'm outside, and I think maybe I should tell her to like sneak out the back or give her some sort of warning that this crazy is about to come to her. After one ring, I get, "Hold on, I'll be right out." And true horror movie fashion, I say, "Rachel, get out of the house."
Get out of the house.
My eyes are like as big as possible. I'm like, "Get out of the house. Like, these girls are coming to beat you up." And from what I heard, Rachel kissed Dan, and Dan has a girlfriend. So if everyone's keeping along at home, you know.
I got the little I'm writing a matrix right here.
That girlfriend happens to have some very angry friends that pre-plan their fights. So lucky for me, this all spills outside in plain view. Dan's trying to mediate, and yelling and pushing starts. Rachel tells them she needs to cancel her Uber. So she comes outside, and as crazy as it sounds, like this whole fight's going on, and everyone just stops because she's like, "I need to go cancel my Uber." So they all stop and start tweeting or whatever, and she comes
out. I slid away for a second. Who canceled their Uber? Nicole?
The girl wanted to cancel it.
Okay,
you know?
Gotcha.
So I give her a nod and just tell her I'm going to shut my Uber off so I could watch the fight, you know. I feel like, you know.
There being a Lunchable involved. Is that coming
yes.
up?
Yes. Yeah. Okay. I feel really invested in the fight now, you know. So I kill my lights and I pull a snack and I turn down my radio so I could concentrate on the fight, you know. But before I could finish my Lunchable, the fight moved out of my view and I no longer had box seats to PB's finest. So the only punch thrown was the one to Dan, who was the boyfriend that supposedly cheated. He storms off with his buddy, and the girls go in a hidden spot. So I finish eating my Lunchable by myself, and I start up my Uber again. I sync up with Dan, who's walking with his friend, you know, and they're all talking about the fight, and his other buddy's going on about this jacuzzi, which he was really excited about. So I sped up. I felt kind of sad, because I got quite fond of Dan, Amy, Rachel, and little Mackie, you know. But I knew it would end eventually. And so I got a ping and went to go get the ride, and immediately it canceled. So I restarted up, and who did I pick up? The two gentlemen still reeling from this fight. So they get in the car, and they're like, "It was just a kiss on the cheek, man." And they're going on about how... you know, they weren't guilty of the fight and all that. So just a heads up, if you're doing, you know, an Uber ride in PB, just make sure you bring snacks.
So are you still doing Uber?
I do it every once in a while. Yeah. I was doing it a lot in January and February when I first started. And then I like to be a jack of all trades and a master of none. So,
right.
You know, I've got with the DJing and, you know, spring coming up, it kind of killed my schedule for Uber, but you know, every time someone hits me up for a ride and I'm available, I'll go get them.
Sweet. Awesome.
Yeah.
Dude, that's just the craziest story. So now how long had you been doing Uber when that happened? Like, was...
No, not long. It was like a week into it.
So you know? your thing is, this is how every Uber ride goes, right?
Like, yeah. And
especially
then
in PB.
Starting to talk to other Uber drivers. They all have their crazy stories too, you know?
Right. Right. That's awesome, dude.
Yeah.
Oh, man. All right. So when you're not doing Uber... Oh, so that's what I was going to ask you, too. DJ Mancat, where'd that come from?
My mom's half tabby.
So, oh, really?
Yes.
Okay.
very sensitive subject.
So yeah, because I was gonna say you're half cat.
Yeah, right. I got right. the name from a friend of mine who we would just go out at night and cause trouble, and he's like, "You're like a cat, man." He's like, "You're like a man cat." And I'm like, "All right." He's an artist too. His name's Ali Garza. He draws for like Marvel, DC. He does Supergirl, all these really cool comic books. So of course he drew me as a man cat, and then I got the artwork, and I'm like, "Yeah, this is nice. I like this name."
That's
so
awesome, dude.
When I had to pick a DJ name, I'm like, "All right. I'm going to be playing other people's music for a living. This is probably the silliest profession to have. I got to pick a name where I can never take myself too seriously, you know?
Right. And I
can
wear a cat. I always wondered how DJs came up with their names, because I think it's one of those rules where if you can't give yourself a nickname. So mm-hmm, I like that mm-hmm. you didn't really come up with it, that they sort of attached to you. You know, because people, when you give yourself a nickname, it's never a good nickname.
Unless it's Ace. I think that's a great nickname to give yourself.
See, I don't know. I guess so. I don't know. To me, it's just, yeah, I don't know. All right. Well, that's pretty awesome. I didn't get to the other stuff we want to talk about, but we'll catch up later in the show. But we're going to take a quick break, and then when we come back, we've got Jesse Arroyo here, who, like I said, I'm going to harass about the Charger Stadium.
Yeah.
See you in a bit.
You're listening to Nixology on ESPN 1700, brought to you by 619 Vodka, who reminds you to always drink responsibly. Find out more at 619vodka.com.
Hey, Mr. Credit here. If you ever catch me at happy hour, you'll probably catch me drinking a vodka martini. I don't always drink vodka, but when I do, I drink 619 Vodka because it's local vodka from right here in San Diego. I know the owner, and you can meet him too. Go to 619vodka.com and think 619 Vodka when you're out there having a good time. That's 619vodka.com. And of course, remember to always drink responsibly.
C.S. Keys here to tell you about San Diego's handcrafted ultra-premium vodka, 619 Vodka. It's distilled and filtered 5 times, gluten-free, and made from 100% pure mountain spring water for a smooth, clean finish. It's a 2-time silver medal winner and a 2-time gold medal winner already in 2013. America's Finest City has America's Finest Vodka that everybody can experience. Just go to the website, 619vodka.com. If you know like I know, you better tell somebody.
Right now at Fuller Ford, lease an all-new 2015 Escape 4-door S 4-wheel drive for a monthly payment of only $169 a month plus tax. With only $2,999 due at lease signing, you can drive off in the car of your dreams. 36-month lease for $169 plus tax per month, $0 security deposit, VIN number C26405. Or lease America's best-selling truck, the brand-new 2015 Ford F-150 4x Supercab. With only $2,999 due at lease signing, this lease can be yours for just $277 plus tax per month. 36-month lease at $277 plus tax per month. Zero security deposit. VIN number A9982. Offers expire June 1st, 2015. Go further with Fuller Ford. Great prices, great selection, and great deals. Where they've treated you like family for over 60 years. Auto Park Drive off the 805 in the Chula Vista Auto Park.
To vote freely is a right that no one can take away. Anyone who tries to deny you this right will be committing a crime. If someone tries to buy, change, or persuade your vote, report it. If someone asks for your voter's credential before the elections, report it. By law, there are sanctions that range from fines to jail time for those who commit electoral crimes. Go to the FAPADE or any district attorney office for more information or to file a report. National Electoral Institute, INE.
Hey, Darren Smith here. I'm with my program director, Mike Shepard. About 9 months ago, he called 844-567-HAIR, the number for La Jolla Hair MD. Mike, how long have you been balding?
Oh, man, this goes back in my late 20s, early 30s. Number of years, you know, it started going, and then it went. And for many years, I looked for a solution to my hair loss, and until recently, didn't really have one.
Well, what was it about La Jolla Hair MD? Why pick up the phone after decades of losing hair? What was it about La Jolla Hair MD?
Well, it's a revolutionary new procedure. It's neograft, and it has none of the horror effects of the previous surgery. The old strip method where you had the huge scar and all the downtime and all the pain, didn't want that. But with neograft, it's a whole new experience. I had my procedure done in an afternoon. I was in a man cave. It was like a day spa for guys.
I love it. And if you call 844-567-HAIR, because you're listening, $1,000 off if you choose to go with the procedure.
Do what I did. Just pick up the phone. You'll be glad you did. You owe it to yourself. LaJollaHairMD.com. 844-567-HAIR.
speed incentive to make the switch to Pennzoil synthetic motor oils? They're formulated for complete engine protection. And here's more incentive. Save up to $25 on your next qualifying Pennzoil oil change with a service certificate. Or, if you'd rather change your own oil, you'll save $5 instantly with a coupon for the purchase of 5 quarts of Pennzoil synthetics. So make the switch and take engine performance to a whole new level. See Pennzoil.com/promotions for details. Offers end 5/31. Restrictions may apply.
Guys, when you buy your clothes at DXL, you look good. But you feel like a rock star. So if you want to look and feel like a... You'll find all the brands you love, waist size 38 and up, all in one awesome store. DXL, you're looking good. Right now, Harbor Bay tees are just $19.99 each when you buy two or more.
And now, back to Nixology on ESPN 1700. Brought to you by 619 Vodka, who reminds you to always drink responsibly. Find out more at 619vodka.com.
All right, welcome back. We're joined in the studio by Jesse Arroyo. If you don't know Jesse, Jesse was a San Diego photographer extraordinaire. In fact, Jesse, I got to tell you, I don't think I've given you proper photo credit, but my Facebook profile picture is a picture you took. It's my favorite freaking picture. Jesse was with the Chargers for years and years. He's worked with local politicians. He's the man around town, and so because of that, he's also been working with the Citizens Advisory Group on the Charger Stadium stuff, kind of liaisoning between fans and the powers that be. And so because of that, I'm dragging him in here today so I can give him crap about this whole Chargers Stadium thing. So welcome, Jesse.
Thank you. I appreciate you having me.
Yeah. So, all right. So yesterday, today, whatever, the day before, they finally announced the Citizens Advisory Group thing. And I had seen pieces of it from before. And it looks pretty good. But really what it comes down to is, are the Chargers going to sign on, right? I mean, and obviously the city and everybody else has to agree. But the real stumbling block here is the Chargers, right?
Absolutely. They have to buy into it. The NFL has to buy into it. The NFL owners have to buy into it. And so they're going to have to take a look at the starting point of the negotiations, which is what this is, and see where they can position themselves to get themselves the best deal and see what we can make a fair deal for the city and the county and then put it all together.
All right. Now, why shouldn't I feel like the Chargers are pretty much already gone? They're looking up in Carson. They're talking to the Raiders, which, I mean, you know, as a diehard Charger, I know you are, and I am, born and raised to, they're talking to the Raiders. What the hell is going on? So why should I, on the one hand, I want to be excited, and I want to say, hey, I want to try and keep them here, and on the other hand, I'm just pissed, man. I let them go play with the Raiders if that's the way they feel about it, you know, and I know the city has done them wrong a time or two, but why should I think they're going to stay, and why should I want them to stay at this point?
Well, there's no done deal yet, and, you know, there's only a plan A, a plan B, and a plan C.
Okay.
So, you know, at first there was the city of industry with Ed Roski, and oh, the Chargers are going to go there. And then right. There was the Staples Center deal, and oh, the Chargers are going to go there. You know, nothing is 100% for sure. So everything's still on the table. Let's find a way to keep the Chargers here in San Diego and make it work.
All right. So for those that haven't checked it out yet, I went online and read a little bit about it. So the proposed stadium is to be, it's on the same property, right? Correct. But they're going to move it to the side and sell off part of the property for some commercial development and that Correct. Sort of thing. Now, the plan also supposedly, quote-unquote, calls for no taxpayer money, right? But the way they're going to do that is to somehow get the Chargers to pony up an extra $100 million, right?
Correct.
And then on top of that, sell seat licenses and all this other stuff. Now, I don't know. Maybe you do. Maybe you can educate me a little bit. I think the 49ers sold something like $300 million in seats rights or something like that.
Correct.
That's not going to happen in San Diego.
That's not going to happen in San Diego.
There's not enough. I mean, there's not enough corporate interest. There's not enough fan interest to sell that kind of money. So what do you think they're going to do? How are they going to make that part work?
The seat licenses?
Yeah, and the extra non-tax, the whole non-tax thing in general.
Well, we have to give credit to National University. They actually did an economic study on the Chargers as a city, our buying power, and measured that based on other NFL teams who have had seat license programs and what they were able to sell. And so what they're estimating is between 100 and 150 million, so let's say 120 million. That's about how much buying power that we could generate and how much interest there is.
Because I'm hearing numbers like 30 million.
30 million?
That's what I'm hearing.
In PSL?
Yeah.
No, that's it. The only thing that comes close to that is 60 million, because one of the suggestions from VP NFL, NFL VP Eric Grubman, was to take the 120 million that you would estimate and divide it into two. 60 million would go to the team, and then 60 million would go towards the operational costs. So the 60 million number has been floating around there as part of the chunk to pay for the stadium. But I haven't heard anything in the 30 million.
All right. And the total bill for this thing is 1.4, right? Is that right?
It's 1.1 on the low end. They've raised ideas to raise up to 1.4 to give them some leeway.
When does a construction project ever come in on the low end?
Well, you know, that's the approach they've taken. You know, they want to get it as lean as possible.
Right.
So.
Okay. All right. So I guess there's that. I just feel like, like I said, diehard Charger fan, would love them to stay. If they do stay, I'll still be a fan. Cause, I mean, they're my team. If they move, they're dead to me. If they move, they're just dead to me. I'll go be a Bronco fan or something. I don't know. I have a list. I'm actually seriously putting together a list, like trying to figure out who it makes sense to be a fan of at this point. But I mean, I hope they stay. Aren't you at least a little bit pissed that they're? I mean, the Raiders, dude. The Raiders and Carson and a stadium together. Aren't you a little mad, especially you having worked for them and whatever? Like, do you get where they're coming from, or are you pissed? I'm a little pissed.
Well, I mean, there's the business side that we always have to take a look at, but there's also the personal side, you know, the heart side. You know, I love the Chargers, and I love the city of San Diego. And to me, the two things together is what really makes this thing magical.
Well, yeah, absolutely. But how come the Spanoses don't feel the same way?
Well, I believe they do. I think they really are trying to stay in San Diego, and they just need a workable plan to make that happen.
So you think this whole Carson thing is just like a card they played to get us off our butts or something? I mean, it wouldn't surprise me, and I wouldn't blame them, honestly. But is that what you think that was, or are they not seriously looking at Carson?
Well, I think they are seriously looking at Carson, you know, because again, no deal is 100% guaranteed, and
sure.
So they need
to
be a
keep their
plan.
Options open.
They got to keep the options open, exactly.
All right. So another thing about this plan is that it. I haven't looked at the latest version, but the way they've set up the facility, is there still going to be room for tailgating and that sort of thing? Because that's half the reason. I mean, that's half the reason I go to the Charger games. You know, I mean, you know, we've gone and partied during tailgating and stuff.
Absolutely.
Are they still going to have a tailgate lot? Because I think the plan is right. There's going to be, I'm going to say left and right, but if you're looking at the north-facing map, the stadium's going to move to the left end of the parking lot, and the middle where the stadium is now is going to be some kind of development, you know, residential, commercial, whatever, mix, whatever it is, and then the parking lot's going to be way on the other side, right? Are they still going to have room for enough parking? Are they going to make us all take the trolley in? What's going to happen there?
Well, there is going to be less parking spaces is what it's looking like. Currently, there's 19,000 spaces, and it's looking like a reduction down to 12,000. So they would expand the public transit and continue that. It's pretty much a foregone conclusion. Parking lots typically don't generate a whole lot of revenue, and that's kind of the stickler about it. What's interesting, though, is that they're opening up the option for a riverfront park, which is pretty sizable, and they've allocated, I think, about 31 acres to that, so it's huge, huge development. And there is possible talk of moving some of the tailgating to that. So there are options out there to get some
kind
of tailgating.
See, now that would be cool, because that riverfront... just sort of random sequitur. I've been traveling a lot recently, and I was in Chicago, and they have their kind of waterfront thing, and San Antonio's was amazing, that river walk. I'd never been there, but it was really cool. And it'd be, you know, our river's kind of dry, but it'd be nice to have something along that San Diego River. That would be cool. Do you know if they plan on expanding that down past the stadium, or is it just, I mean, is it part of the stadium project, I guess, or is it something separate that just might happen to be next to the stadium?
It would be an entire city development. So the stuff that they were talking about building south of the river would not necessarily be part of the stadium, but it could be. What I'd personally like to see is access. Right now, there is no access from the riverside to
like
the
pedestrian
stadium.
Walkways or something like
exactly.
That.
Exactly.
Okay.
Opening that section up actually would alleviate a lot of the traffic on Friars Road and would give additional parking options there on the south side. And these are all things that still need to be worked out, but they are beautiful possibilities if we can make it all work.
All right. And the one other thing to tie it back into booze here is I also read like 2 weeks ago, and you might not know much about this, I'll just ask you, the concession rights are up for Qualcomm. And they're talking to new concessioners and the existing one. I forget who they are. There's like three or four. What's that?
Center Plate.
That's right. Center Plate, whose CEO had some kind of problem for kicking a dog. I don't know. Something weird about that. So he's not in the mix, but he's got somebody else. And there's a couple of others. And some of the proposals I've seen would jack the food and beverage prices through the roof, too. So now we're talking PSLs and obviously, it's the NFL and it's a great product and they should get whatever they can get, right? But I mean, is it going to become just ridiculously unaffordable for a regular San Diegan to go to the game anymore?
I think we could expect some price increases. I mean, it's like moving into a new house. You know, you're moving out of that small house that you had in 1965, and now you're getting a new 2018 stadium. So with all the bells and whistles that go with that, of course, a higher price tag would come with it. But that's part of what the fan coalitions are starting to do, is say, hey, don't forget us. You know, we need to make this affordable and accessible for families.
Okay, so there's going to be none of this ticket guarantee kind of stuff anymore, or is that part of the deal too? Like, how? Like, what if they raise the prices and they can't, and attendance goes down, and are the Chargers wanting to build contingencies in for that? How is that going to work? Do you know?
Well, they're scaling back the number of available seating. So instead of being a 70,000 seat stadium, it's going to be reduced to 65.
And the NFL's okay with that for Super Bowls and stuff like that?
Yeah, because it is expandable. It would be expandable to 72, 73, depending on what the final numbers are. So it's something that can be expandable for the Super Bowl type things. But for day-to-day operations, it would be a smaller scale. That would be more suitable for San Diego.
How would you add those seats?
How would you add those seats? Mm-hmm. I'd have to defer to the engineers on that one.
Yeah. I don't know if they do. There are a few stadiums that do that where they have like the ability to expand capacity. I don't know exactly how
it just reminds me of like high school gym where they just like pull out the bleachers. Yeah. Yeah, we're good.
That's probably what it would be.
One Hopefully. Example is in Atlanta, they're talking about just having the upper deck and then being able to seal that off with banners. And it would look picturesque. It wouldn't look like just a big empty.
That would be a stadium. Problem here in San Diego if they had to use banners to cover them up.
Well, I think exactly. When they talk about multi-use, think they were talking about like the MLS team, which wouldn't fill a 60 or 70,000 stadium.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
So for some of those smaller events.
Right. And there's not going to be as many luxury boxes and things like that, right?
Well, there's going to be more luxury boxes.
Yeah, bring.
I mean, but I guess more. I meant not as many as like some of these other new stadiums that are going up, right? It's not going to be kind of as crazy with the bells and whistles.
Luxury stadiums and the suites are huge, huge revenue drivers, and so that was one of the arguments of the need
to put
for.
Them in there. Okay.
Yeah, exactly. So I expect that to be significantly upgraded.
All right. Cool. Yeah. Well, before I let you go, I'm going to put you on the spot. Percentage, what do you think? Are they going to stay? Is it not going to stay? This new plan sounds pretty good. I have to admit, I was kind of impressed. What do you think the chances are of them actually sticking around? I mean, it's a lot of moving pieces, but...
Yeah.
You think they'll be here in a couple of years? Because they're talking 2020 for this stadium to be built, right?
Yeah, hopefully.
Okay.
For it to be operational.
So come on, give me a percentage.
Oh. Now you really got it. They just came out yesterday.
It's a literal spotlight on them right now.
Yeah, there's still...
I mean, you know the players more than I do. You think the team is going to, amenable to it, et cetera, et cetera. I guess that's what I'm asking.
Sure.
Like, what's your confidence? Do you think the team will like this? Do you think it's good? The city will go for it, et cetera?
I think they're still kind of far apart on negotiations.
Okay.
But I think this is an inch closer, So, I'm going to stay hopeful. I'm going to stay positive and continue to pump energy into this because I really think that a viable San Diego stadium is still on the table.
All right.
We're going to work
I hope you're right, man. I really hope you're right. I do not want to have to become a Broncos fan. I'm really not looking forward to that. All right, Jesse. Well, thanks. Before I let you go, so it's Jesse ArroyoPhotography.com, right?
ArroyoPhotos.com.
Oh, ArroyoPhotos. Yeah, sorry about that. ArroyoPhotos.com. Thanks for coming in, man. Really appreciate it.
Always great to see you.
Right, we'll be back in a minute.
Hey, Mr. Credit here. If you ever catch me at happy hour, you'll probably catch me drinking a vodka martini. Now, I don't always drink vodka, but when I do, I drink 619 Vodka because it's local vodka from right here in San Diego. I know the owner, and you can meet him too. Go to 619vodka.com and think 619 Vodka when you're out there having a good time. That's 619vodka.com. And of course, remember to always drink responsibly.
C.S. Keys here to tell you about San Diego's handcrafted ultra-premium vodka.
619 Vodka. It's distilled and filtered five times, gluten-free, and made from 100% pure mountain spring water for a smooth, clean finish. It's a two-time silver medal winner and a two-time gold medal winner already in 2013. America's Finest City has America's Finest Vodka that everybody can experience. Just go to the website, 619vodka.com. If you know like I know, you better tell somebody.
You're listening to Guy Talk, live from the Sport Clips Haircuts locker room. Caller, you're on the air.
My girlfriend beat me playing one-on-one.
Whoa, you need to get your man card back, man.
You think?
Hit up a Sport Clips and get an awesome haircut experience and some quality man time.
I don't know. My girlfriend always takes me to her salon.
Nonsense. Be your own man and get a great haircut in a guy-friendly place from stylists who know what guys need.
You may be right.
Sure I'm right. Take your cut to the Sport Clips MVP level with a relaxing shampoo and our legendary hot steam towel.
That sounds awesome.
And you know those shows about cupcakes and flowers you probably watch with your girlfriend?
Yeah.
Well, you won't find any of those at Sport Clips. We've got TVs at every station doing what TVs were invented to do. Show sports all day.
I am there.
Now pick up your manhood, grab your Y chromosome, and get down to Sport Clips and ask for the MVP. That's all the time we have today on Guy Talk, brought to you by Sport Clips, where it's good to be a guy.
This is John Feinstein, and this is a CBS Sports Minute. Derek Gordon is transferring from the University of Massachusetts to play his final season of college basketball at Seton Hall. Given that Gordon averaged 9.8 points and 4.9 rebounds at UMass last winter, this is a one-paragraph story everywhere except the Seton Hall student newspaper. Except for this, a little more than a year ago, Gordon became the first major college basketball player to come out as being gay. And for this, Gordon says some coaches didn't want him as a transfer because he's gay. It's sad, but there's no doubt Gordon is telling the truth, because especially in jock world, there's still resistance to gay athletes, even though the progress made in the last 10 years is remarkable. What's also sad, though, is Gordon leaving his UMass teammates, who he says were universally supportive of him behind. Loyalty should be a two-way street. I'm John Feinstein.
As a business owner, I can tell you that your company is only as good as the people you hire. But when you're short-staffed, there's no time to deal with all the different job sites. Until now. Thanks to ZipRecruiter.com, I can post to 100-plus job sites with one single click and have the highest chance of finding that perfect candidate. Just post once, and within 24 hours, watch your candidates roll in to ZipRecruiter's easy-to-use interface. Try ZipRecruiter for free at ZipRecruiter.com/go. That's ZipRecruiter.com/go.
Kid, let me paint you a picture. Tuesday night, your cog belt goes bust. Who will help you get what you need fast? Without the hoops, hurdles, or headaches? Grainger, that's who. I love Grainger. They got a wide variety of products and solutions. Grainger makes it easy to get everything we need and answers for when we're not sure what the answer is. Now, kid, let me paint you another picture. It looks like a mop, a basement bathroom, and you all over it. Get it? Got it? Good. Call clickgrainger.com or stop by. Grainger. For the ones who get it done.
And now, back to Nixology on ESPN 1700. Brought to you by 619 Vodka, who reminds you to always drink responsibly. Find out more at 619vodka.com.
All right, welcome back. So, what do you guys think? Are the Chargers sticking around?
I mean, there's three cities and four NFL teams that are looking for a place right now. I don't see San Diego being the one out of it. I mean, I know San Antonio's really interested. I would like to see Oakland go to San Antonio.
I don't care where Oakland goes.
Fair enough.
I mean, I guess out of California would be nice. Out of the AFC West would be nice.
Yeah, I mean, well, see, I'm from the East Coast, and for me, this is like the Red Sox going to play with the Yankees. Like, it would just break my heart. So right. I don't understand why that's something that's being proposed on the personal side. On the business side, you get it, but
I get it on the business side. Yeah, like I said, the city's jerked the team around enough times where, I mean, if I was the owner, I'd probably be pissed too.
It's like a high school relationship. Yeah. Well, I'm gonna go with the Raiders. So I'll see you.
I think that's when I just jumped off the bus. I'm like, really, with the Raiders? You couldn't do a deal with another team to put a stadium together? Anyway, all right. Enough football. All right. So we're gonna talk pickles. We're joined by Gerald Farver. He's the owner of Farve's Pickles. I met Jared a few years ago when he was first starting out with this, and these pickles are freaking amazing. They're based on a recipe his grandmother had back in the day. Decided to bring them back, and now put his own twist on them and do some really cool things like beer and bourbon infused pretzels. Infused the right word. They're all over San Diego now. If you get a chance, you got to check them out. It's farvespickles.com, and they're on Facebook, Twitter, all that good stuff. Anyway, welcome, Jared.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Yeah, dude. I'm excited. So when did you started 4 years ago? Is that right with these?
I got the recipe probably 3 years ago from my mother.
Okay.
It was just one of those things that she made once a year, and it just wasn't enough for me to, you know, have her ship one jar once a year. So I got the recipe, and anything culinary, you know, related, I'm into. I cook every single night, you know, all that kind of stuff.
Well, when you and I first met too, we were talking about the whole pickles thing, and I know pickles are a weird thing for a booze show, but you know, we were talking about for Bloody Marys and things like that. And my big beef was I heard
you weren't a Bloody Mary fan.
I'm not a Bloody Mary fan. That is true. So, yeah, I have to defer on that.
I had no idea. I came to your house, and I'm trying to sell you on this idea, and you're like,
dude,
yeah,
I remember
they taste
that.
Great.
Well, no, and people love Bloody Marys. I've learned a long time ago I'm not the arbiter of taste in the world. So, yeah, Bloody Mary, just tomato juice makes no sense to me in the first place.
I guess if you have to
drink it, you might want to throw some vodka in it and some other things.
Yeah, I understand what you're saying.
Tomato juice was like a punishment almost. I don't know what the heck. But anyway, I do love pickles, and you and I talked about that the first time, and it's hard to get, I don't know, I guess what I consider good pickles. I mean,
as far as San Diego goes, you know, everything's machine packed wherever you go. As far as I know, I'm the only, you know, local pickle company,
right?
Which is a big advantage, but I think there's a few fermented guys that are out here that do kimchi and do
sauerkraut, stuff
sauerkraut
like that. Right?
And I think they probably do pickles. But anyway,
so let's talk about that, because what I was curious about, and I didn't realize this until just recently, is that, you know, obviously pickles are awesome, but now you're doing them with beers and bourbons as well.
Yeah. So the kitchen that I use downtown,
it's Taste and Thirst.
Okay. And I basically make them pickles, and they were coming up with an idea of doing beer battered fried pickles for their menu.
Oh, cool. Okay.
And it just kind of hit me. I thought beer and pickles. And I think I was Googling a beer batter recipe, and I came across a company making beer infused pickles.
Okay.
And so I just did a little research and tried a few different things, tried to come up with my own, you know, beer infused pickle. And we came up with one.
That's sweet, dude.
It's an IPA from Mission Brewery. I've tried a bunch of different IPAs. You know, I'm not stuck on Mission Breweries, but...
Well, so that's what I was going to ask. So, I guess you answered my question there. So, as far as the types of beer that would even work in a pickle...
There's only a few. So it's not like you can just pour
any beer in there.
It's got to be something that can come through... that you can distinguish. You know, the thing is, you can really manipulate a pickle. I mean, a cucumber... has a cucumber flavor, but I mean, you can really turn it into what you want to turn it into, whether it's spicy or what. I mean,
right,
you pour vanilla
right
in there. I mean, tons of stuff that you can do. But the IPA came through. I added habanero. There's some paprika in there. There's cumin.
So you're doing the one. You're not. I mean, are there plans to maybe do, I don't know, different kinds of, like, you know, IPA beer, or am I getting too crazy with the pickles?
Well, no, that could be all day long, and now we have how many breweries here? So it's unlimited.
972, and I think. It's, I don't know, it's a ridiculous number of breweries.
I just wanted to
I just talked to the guys this weekend from Henneberry Whiskey, and they're looking to they're trying to put their distillery together down here, and they've had 5 leases fall through because every time they're in competition for a lease, a brewery comes and takes. I'm not joking about the number of breweries. Yeah. There's probably 10 breweries within a mile of my house. Mm-hmm. It's insane.
Yeah.
You could go all day long with the beer and the pickles.
And I tried actually Thorn Street. I used their Relay IPA.
Okay. We had them on last a couple weeks ago.
Yeah, I saw that. They give me a little bit better deal than Mission Brewery, so I may end up using theirs. There's actually,
you hear that, Mission?
There's come actually.
Do you want to get pickles or not?
Yeah, theirs tastes really, really good, and I know Dennis and some of the guys there, and they're awesome. I make pickles for Home and Away, his place in Old Town.
Oh, cool. Yeah, yeah. I haven't been there yet, but I heard good things.
It's awesome. I'm there all the time. Anytime my girlfriend goes out of town or whatever, I'm just sitting there.
I got to get them to carry 619.
Because you're home and she's away.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, they still don't carry 619. I'm a little bitter about that, but we'll get it.
I'll talk to them.
Yeah,
ding.
dude, tell them it's the only thing to pair with your pickles for Bloody Marys.
Exactly.
If they're putting anything else in, they're screwing it up, man.
You're right. Yeah. So there's so many ways having this pickle company. I mean, there's so many ways to market it through other people's companies and all these other businesses. Yeah. And as far as the beer goes, that was like, I could think about this all day long. So I just kind of picked up Mission real quick. And
all right, so you brought some of these, right? I want to try some of these, man.
So my God, they're a little spicy.
So these, you said they have habanero in them too.
There's habanero. They're not too spicy,
I'll
but
give it a try.
You know,
I like ones too. If you don't want to get too crazy, these are regular deal. That's my grandma's recipe. So
I like pickles, like I guess any person would. Like if I get a sandwich that's on the plate, I'm excited about it. But when you open these and put them in front of me, it wafted.
A little bit of it?
Oh man, and I'm like, I've never wanted to eat a pickle more in my life than I do right now. So
get it going.
Okay.
Oh, these are good, man.
Those first ones, those are really good.
These,
yeah.
It's got a good spice to it.
See, but I'm the other way around. I'm the guy that goes to the fair and is walking around with a giant dill pickle. Yeah. You know, like instead of the turkey leg, I'm eating the pickle, man. I love me a good pickle.
So these are dill pickles. The other thing, which is a little bit crazy, I got a little crazy and just went out. I did carrots. I do, a mixed vegetable. I do a whole bunch of different stuff.
I'm getting texts from friends who say they want beer pickles, by the way.
Perfect. Well, they can get them at a lot of different places.
Wow, that's good.
I did carrots that I do with ginger, so they're just a kind of a sweet ginger carrot.
And okay, you had me in hello. I love ginger. I love carrots.
Get your...
Yeah, I'm going to... Pardon me while I crunch on the air.
Man, and this is like a Bloody Mary, like, heaven right here. You got the carrots. So, just a quick question. I know I already have friends that love pickles. What's the easiest way for them to get these?
You know...
Are you doing my job now?
Well, you were eating a pickle, so I was just trying to...
Thanks, man. No, jump in and... No, it's perfect. This is awesome.
If you go on the website, farfspickles.com, you can... See where we're at. We're in 20 locations. Our biggest commercial grocery store is Jimbo's. It's an all-natural food store, and they sell 4 of our products. One is the Dirty Blonde Ginger Carrots, which my girlfriend named.
You can deliver boxes of those to my house anytime you want.
You can do amazing. Just for free?
You can be like Girl Scout cookies, man.
We'll trade vodka.
Okay. Yeah, well, I'll do that any day. So I used Mission Brewery, again, their blonde ale. Just to kind of beef it up and give it like some zing, give it some, you know, something different in there, and believe it or not, like that kind of comes through, and there's some sweetness in it, and it's a lighter beer, but it has a lot of flavor. So
that's in the carrots.
That's in the carrots. Yeah,
those are awesome, dude. Those are really
those
awesome.
Are one of my favorite ones.
Hey, which one you want, Bob?
Let's try the carrot.
Let's get some more. We're talking about them, and I'm like, I'm really.
We need portable mics so we can pass stuff around the studio a little easier.
So I mean, at the end of the day, there's so many things. I've got so many recipes. I make some with bourbon that are a sweeter pickle.
Yeah, bourbon, dude. So you didn't bring any of those. I'm a little upset.
So I'm just kind of backed up. I keep, you know,
So the bourbons are they still dill, or are they sweet?
They're not dill at all. They're just sweeter. Sweet. I'm not a huge sweet pickle fan, but it's basically a bread and butter pickle with bourbon in it.
Okay.
And
any particular bourbon? Do we want to say? Do we care? They're not giving you any help, are they?
They're not.
Okay.
So
that's fine.
But the first one I did, which is one of my favorites, is Buffalo Trace.
Nice.
Oh, cool. Nice. Excellent.
So I mean, that was kind of the first run, and obviously it's expensive to do that kind of thing. So everything that we do is again, local.
Now you're doing these by hand, right? You're the one in the kitchen sweating in the middle of the night and putting things in jars.
Everything's cut by hand. Everything's hand-packed. Everything's done by hand. So, you know, these pickles, I cut these before I brought them in, and I put them in the fridge so they were cold and everything. But you're going to pull out, you know, two spears that are completely different sizes. Right. And so I get what I get.
Because you're sipping on the bourbon while you're cutting the
pickles. Exactly.
Right. No, I don't blame you. So, that's what I'd be doing.
Yeah. So you can tell that it's handmade and hand-packed and handcrafted and, you know, all that thing. And right. We don't cut corners. Everything's expensive for me to do. And that's the way it is.
I'll put you on the spot, Mark. You carry these at Holiday Wine Cellar?
No, but I was talking to
him. We got to get these in there. Get them in there, dude.
I was mentioning we need
put
to carry
next
this.
To the Bloody Mary mix, the vodka, whatever. They'll fly off the shelf. It's crazy. Yeah.
I'll go to the tasting.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Actually, that's true because you go.
We could sample the vodka and
vodka,
do a little bit of pickles
too. Sweet, dude. Yeah.
So that's the other thing. I even thought, well, vodka was. Someone said vodka because we always talk about Bloody Marys, and I thought, I don't know if that's something that is going to work.
It's backwards because vodka doesn't have it. Like we're doing. I don't know if I talked to you about this. We're getting ready to do some fusions.
I heard you talking about
it. The scorpion pepper and things like that.
In fact,
I had a drink the other day.
No cotton candy vodka.
You know what? If I could figure out a way to jam cotton candy in a vodka jar. No, I had a drink the other day. In fact, it was at Tacotopia this weekend. Mm. There's a company that had like horchata and other stuff like that. And they had a watermelon ginger mint drink. And it was phenomenal. And my first thought was, this needs vodka. Like watermelon ginger mint vodka. Mm-hmm. But I don't know. That's probably way too complicated for us to do. So vodka flavored pickles probably wouldn't work, but there's other stuff we could do. And somebody even recommended to me the other day that we try and do, and I think there is one, a pickle vodka.
Wow.
In fact,
that's
I need to
the
look
other way around.
Up.
That would be.
You telling me that? Somebody was telling me there's a pickle vodka, and I love a good pickleback, so I'm like, if I could do a shot of whiskey and then a shot of pickle vodka. Instead of just pickle juice,
then you'd be
right. Do a little double shot.
You're up in the game, right there.
Yeah, no, totally. If you're gonna do it, you know, put a little vodka in it. So I don't know how to do pickle vodka.
Call him to come pick you up.
Yeah, maybe we should work together. Exactly. Call him an Uber if he's not busy. If he's not busy officiating a fight in a PB somewhere. Yeah. No. I mean, we should talk offline. Maybe try and figure out a way to do some kind of pickle infused vodka.
I did. Yeah, and I did the same thing. I think bourbon and beer, as far as my pickling goes, is probably what I'm going to stay with, but I did try a gin one that I did mint and juniper berries and some sugar, and it was a little weird, but
gin's tough because there's so many
really
different, because every gin's got different botanicals, and you'd really have to kind of work hard to find one that works, right?
Yeah, but the bourbon one is amazing. It's just it's a little sweet. So
dude,
it's,
they killed half that
like
jar
it.
of.
They're so good.
That, that'll be $5.
I put a bunch in my pocket too for later. That's how much I like these things.
All right, awesome. So they can get them around town at Jimbo's and then other Jimbo's, obviously like Bottlecraft in North Park. We talked about off the air.
Hart and Trotter in North Park, which is a butcher place.
Oh. I want to check that place out.
Yeah.
Now I got a great excuse to go. That's right off El Cajon, right?
That's right off El Cajon.
Yeah,
and
I got to check that place out.
And
okay, cool.
They sell them quicker than almost anybody. Where else? Downtown, one of my first accounts, Zanzibar Cafe.
Oh, nice.
They sell them there.
Made famous by Jack Black, right?
I don't know. Oh, yeah.
Jack Black. Wasn't that Jason Mraz too, or
that's
something?
Some song, or
he mentioned in this song.
Oh, yeah, he does mention his song. Yeah. Well, cool, dude, man. Thanks for coming in. That stuff is awesome. Yeah, and like I said, trade pickles for vodka anytime. Especially the carrots, man. Totally.
I will do that.
All right,
thanks
sweet,
for having me,
dude.
On.
Yeah, so they're available around town. FarmsPickles.com. And when we come back, we'll talk about what's going on this weekend and so goldfish races.
Yeah,
and eat more pickles.
Yeah, need more pickles. We'll be right back.
You're listening to Nixology on ESPN 1700, brought to you by 619 Vodka, who reminds you to always drink responsibly. Find out more at 619vodka.com.
Hey, Mr. Credit here. If you ever catch me at happy hour, you'll probably catch me drinking a vodka martini. Now, I don't always drink vodka, but when I do, I drink 619 Vodka because it's local vodka from right here in San Diego. I know the owner, and you can meet him too. Go to 619vodka.com and think 619 Vodka when you're out there having a good time. That's 619vodka.com. And of course, remember to always drink responsibly.
C.S. Keys here to tell you about San Diego's handcrafted ultra-premium vodka, 619 Vodka. It's distilled and filtered 5 times, gluten-free, and made from 100% pure mountain spring water for a smooth, clean finish. It's a 2-time silver medal winner and a 2-time gold medal winner already in 2013. America's Finest City has America's Finest Vodka that everybody can experience. Just go to the website, 619vodka.com. If you know like I know, you better tell somebody.
We've all heard horror stories about getting robbed on Craigslist. Some cities even tell citizens to meet at the local police station to do their Craigslist transactions. San Diegans don't need to go to jail in order to buy or sell safely. We're home to a great tech company that's created a safe, modern marketplace. Antengo has millions of listings, real user profiles, and secure payments. To use Antengo, go to Mighty1090.com where you'll see a big green check mark. Click and sign up with PayPal to get the PayPal guarantee when transacting.
Right now at Fuller Ford, lease an all-new 2015 Escape 4-door S 4-wheel drive for a monthly payment of only $169 a month plus tax. With only $2,999 due at lease signing, you can drive off in the car of your dreams. 36-month lease for $169 plus tax per month, $0 security deposit, VIN number C26405. Or lease America's best-selling truck, the brand-new 2015 Ford F-150 4x Supercab. With only $2,999 due at lease signing, this lease can be yours for just $277 plus tax per month. 36-month lease at $277 plus tax per month. Zero security deposit. VIN number A9982. Offers expire June 1st, 2015. Go further with Fuller Ford. Great prices, great selection, and great deals. Where they've treated you like family for over 60 years. Auto Park Drive off the 805 in the Chula Vista Auto Park.
Brian Scudamore from 1-800-GOT-JUNK.
The outer space guys, right?
All you have to do is point. My main man, Tom.
Hello.
My other main man, Tom.
Hi. It's gonna take more than just pointing to get this bad boy out of here.
That's a big one, all right.
Biggest I've ever seen.
Biggest one ever made, fellas.
Point to it, sir.
I already told you.
Please? Give us a chance.
You really think that just pointing is going to be enough to...
Son of a biscuit eater!
That's a new one.
We should write that down.
Will there be anything else, sir?
Gosh, that was easy.
Oh, the work is just beginning.
Now we have to recycle the recyclables.
We've been doing that since before it was fashionable.
And make sure everything gets to the right place.
Only about a third of this stuff will be thrown away?
That's right. So spread the word. When junk needs to disappear,
just call 1-800-GOT-JUNK.
Or visit 1-800-GOT-JUNK.com.
In this campaign, the pawn has reminded you about the reality of the PRI government. But above all, the pawn plans to change the course with good ideas. One, they'll stop the PRI control of the police. Two, they'll assure the existence of the municipal police and increase their wages. Three, they'll protect those that report crimes. The trio of change. 1, 2, 3, for you, for everyone. Change the course with good ideas. National Action Party.
Sometimes it helps to have the opinion of an expert.
Like for sports analysis, you want to listen to a guy who actually played professional sports.
Or a respected sports journalist.
Sure, if you're talking about $500 haircuts, I think you'd have a lot to say.
It was $400.
But if you're looking for a great set of tires...
Trust Goodyear. From fire trucks to race cars, Goodyear tires offer superior traction, handling, and performance.
And if experts choose Goodyear, what's stopping you? Go to Goodyear.com to find the right tire and store for you.
Goodyear. More driven.
Welcome to Million.
All right, guys, welcome back. We're still stuffing our faces with pickles over here.
Mm-hmm. Pickles.
Man, these are pickle, so good. So, Jared, you were saying you have a tasting coming up at Williams-Sonoma?
At Williams-Sonoma, yeah. I actually randomly got a call from their manager and wants me to... They do, like, an artisan thing once a month or every weekend. I just did it last week.
Okay.
I'm going to do it again right before Father's Day, June 20th. So, at the Fashion Valley Mall from 12 to 4, I'll be there. You can come... Taste some pickles.
Yeah, so you want to try some of these things, get down there for that for sure. All right, and then we're just going to talk about things that are going on this weekend. Hang on. Oh, yeah, sure, dude. So, a few things going on. This is Tiki Beat Friday?
Yes.
Friday night is the City Beat annual summer launch party called Tiki Beat. It's at the Lafayette Hotel.
That's going to be a big
event.
And,
Bo, you're going to be there, too? You're
working on? I'm going to be at the event, and I'm supporting Lafayette. I do their pool party first Saturday of every month.
It's always fun.
Oh, so good. So, yeah, I'm going to go support there. And then after, we're doing a big party at the AC Lounge.
Oh, nice.
We got Digital Lizards of Doom playing, which is really cool. This band is like a concept band. It's like a comic book that he has music to. So he has like the characters act out on stage. It's wild.
That's pretty rad. That's pretty
you
awesome.
Gotta check
really?
It out. Yeah, and then it's put on by Noise Cartel Records. So we'll be there. That's kind of unofficial after party for the Tiki. We're all gonna go over there after. So AC Lounge, and they have that light up dance floor.
Yeah.
So I'll be playing Billie Jean on repeat.
Nice. Awesome. All right. So not to get you in trouble, but a little Lafayette. So Lafayette, dude. We brought that up in the break. What is up with those guys? Because they did the pool parties all summer a couple years ago, and then they stopped them for like a year because they were getting noise complaints.
Yes, yeah, they were getting
somebody died in the pool or something.
Well, Nick, that was where I first met you, I think.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah,
no,
did that really happened.
Oh yeah, somebody died overnight. Yeah, some homeless person managed to jump the fence and get into the pool, and when people woke up in the morning, he was just floating in the pool.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
So
on a happy note, though, these pool parties are gonna be great.
But no, but they weren't having the pool parties for a while, right? Or they weren't doing like amplified music or something. They were kind of are they back to doing that stuff now?
I think probably because of the past, and then also they're really particular about their brand, from what I'm aware of.
Yeah.
And their whole vibe is not like dive, you know.
Right.
And I mean,
right.
Dive by, like,
and they got kind of like that, yeah, like that or Intervention or whatever. But
yeah,
I loved partying at that place, man. I'd go get a room like once a month. Mm-hmm. Back when they
the
were
little
doing
bungalows
them.
There.
Yeah. Oh, yeah,
so
it's
fun.
Awesome, dude. Your poolside.
So,
yeah.
Yeah. Well, they've reinvented it, and now instead of that having that crazy party vibe, there's DJs there and everyone's by the pool, but the music, we've actually switched over. I've been doing Motown, 80s, 90s throwbacks, and some modern stuff if it feels right.
See, that's awesome.
Yeah, we changed the vibe a lot, and it's been going really well.
All right. First Saturday of the month you're there?
First Saturday of the month, right, which will fall on July 4th this year.
Sweet.
Yes.
Oh, man. Yeah, and then there's Sing, Dance, Crawl that's going on this weekend, which is already sold out. It sells out every time. And then Rolling Stones. But back with the Rolling Stones, there. I hear there is goldfish racing going on somewhere tonight.
You know, I heard that too.
I think so.
You have
to explain to me how this goldfish racing works.
Actually, Haji and I, we've been doing this for years. This went back from a bar called the Surf and Saddle, and it got rebranded and bought by some new guys. Now it's a Saddle Bar. It's right next to the Belly Up in Solana Beach.
Oh, see, that's why I wasn't getting the name, because I remember it as Surf and Saddle.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so this used to be, I think it was Torrey Pines, the Hala High School kids used to go there, and it was Tuesday night. This bar would be over capacity with people goldfish racing. It's like, think of like the Indiana Jones movie where they're all in there illegally betting on stuff. Like,
right.
This is what it was.
Totally.
People were smoking.
Yeah.
Just yelling at fish.
Yeah.
At the top of their lungs.
It was an old Asian
Another
lady smoking a cigarette.
Another place I remember going into and rarely remember leaving.
Yeah,
yeah, exactly.
So now we do it again, and now it's on Tuesday nights, goldfish racing. Actually, anyone who is listening who wants to mention 619 Vodka, your race will be on the house tonight. We'll get you in for free to do it. We have all kinds of fun prizes. Me and Haji will be there doing the goldfish racing.
Sweet. And then you wanted to mention something about if they come up, they can come up to the store.
If you come to the store at Holiday Wine Cellar, mention, 619 Vodka, and we'll give you 15% off your purchase. So
all right.
Pop on in. Get a discount.
Sweet. What time does the goldfish leave the gate? What is it?
How
does
that works. Let's use that.
Do you have like a big announcer guy?
A whistle.
And they approach the starting gate.
I am the announcer guy.
Are you?
Yes.
Sweet.
And I will probably make fun
of
everyone.
Dude, I might have to make a pilgrimage out there just to check that out.
It is a lot of fun. You get out of towners and people from the races that come out depending on the season, so on a Tuesday night you really can't beat anything else in town to do besides this. So come on out, we start around 10 o'clock.
Awesome. All right, well, I want to thank all my guests. Jared, thanks for coming in. Pickles were awesome.
Yeah, thank you.
ForestPickles.com, DJ Mancat,
now
Mark Hodges, and of course Jesse Arroyo coming in talking about the Chargers. Thanks again, guys, for coming in, and we'll see you all next week.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you for listening to Nixology on